Okay, what's good, YouTube family? There's been a lot of witnesses in this case who came forward, and yet we don't hear Houston Police Department bringing any of them up, speaking about any of the eyewitnesses during that case, during that trial, during that situation. But there was a witness that I'm seeing on Reddit going crazy. I don't know how actual this witness or credible this witness is. Just like the other witnesses, we're gonna go back to their stories and what they said to see if it's matching up. But this eyewitness brings up the takeoff situation, and they're actually blaming the mob right now. They're saying they seen certain parties of Prince and them that was there, who was associates of them. And I don't know how factual that is, but we're gonna break this down. I need y'all to do me one favor, is hit that like button, hit that notification bell. Thank you for rocking out with the I Smoke Hip Hop Live platform. Salute the I Smoke Hip Hop Nation. I am your guy, DJ Blessed One. Salute the Pesh Mayweather. Follow folks on YouTube right now and go to his Instagram also and show some love one time, man. We got to keep this thing rocking, grooving, and moving. Now, this witness was given by several bloggers. I seen it trending, but you know I'm going to try to follow it and watch it. I couldn't see the actual video besides the pictures right here. You know, the manager who was working there of the bowling alley said a lot of things they seen, and we did hear the 911 call that they gave out to us too. You know what I mean? It was a lot to the 911 situation, which was pretty much she seen a lot of large entourage. We'll go to that a little bit later. Let me just stick to y'all why I'm saying what I'm saying. Now, if this witness is true from what she's saying, she can cause certain members of a party in trouble just based on connections. You know what I mean? Connections to, if you're saying it's Prince family in them, their entourage in them. So all the focal focus would only be on that. But this is why I don't think that's going to be the case. We know about ties and connections to who got who and what, when and where already. That's all I wanted to throw out there. But the 911 call is, I'm trying to put that up for y'all. The 911 call was the one that I needed y'all to hear. Hang on for me right quick. Let's go to the 911 call right quick, because I'm seeing if it's the same manager. I like seeing the actual thing, y'all. Hang on. We're going to substantiate it to see if this is the same voice from this lady here in the videos I've seen.
The channel once.
Hello, check out 22B23, 1212 Grand Plaza. Okay, here we go. For discharge and firearms. Been 5 shots fired downstairs, from downstairs outside near 2004.
I ain't being funny. It does sound like a white lady, and it does sound like the manager. I'm being honest with you. That's what I was trying to verify. We'll go back to the 911 video, but we had to just verify that for the sake of the people watching. Now, y'all already know, but I did a video showing you HPD got all the 4K videos. They got, it's over 80 videos in that bowling alley area, not even including the ones outside or in that whole plaza and facility. I think it's 810 or 801, whatever that area is called. But y'all already know in Houston what I'm talking about, the 810 billiards. But it's a lot of cameras in that area. So for them folks to think HPD don't have all this already, you wildin', bro. You wildin' right now. Now, let's go back to some witness accounts before we play the 911 footage. I like keeping some of these receipts just to, you feel me, look at it and have a mutual breakdown in what we know without, you know what I'm saying, being extra. Let's go to the very first witness, which was a street nigga who gave this to Sean Cotton in the shade room. He posted a picture of them inside the actual area playing the dice games. He tells you who started what it began with. In a way, he, even though he's blaming Quavo, but he admitted it, that Quavo got into it with one of the mob, as you seen right here. So he already right there pinpointed and blamed the mob. That's witness number one, that's vital, who was right there. We're going to get to it. Y'all going to see what makes sense. That's witness number one, right? This witness broke it down. Then we had a witness on the Storm Monroe show. Let's play that one right quick, because that's vital too. This witness puts it on the mob as well.
We were all there when all this happened. I just left from HPD. First of all, in order to be around Jazz Prince, You have to be searched. None of us had guns, but Jazz people had guns. Okay. All of this about this was over a dice game. This shit started in Fifth Ward around 9:30.
She telling you it started in Fifth Ward. Now about the guns part, we seen multiple people with it on videos. So that one, I can't take her serious with that one. But she's saying, oh, this started at the Fifth Ward. You feel me?
10 last night. So this had nothing to do with no damn dice game, with no money situation or anything like that. And the only reason why I'm not going to great details, because I live in Houston and the Prince family know me. But all of the camps, because Takeoff and Quavo was basically trying to be the mediator between the people who were arguing.
She's establishing a motive, a reason, and probable cause in this case, bro. Like, you think them folks ain't listening to all this?
Oh, shit.
And so everybody's saying, oh, well, this is Quavo fault. Quavo had nothing to do with the shit y'all talking about, bro. Y'all was not there when this happened. It had nothing to do with that. So all these 30 seconds videos that they're seeing, this and that, everybody's saying, well, he didn't act the way how he act went up.
She substantiated reasons and motives right there on that one. Now let's go to the other ones. The witnesses who actually was in the interrogation room as well, who wrote down her statement. Now she said this. She took a picture. There go the girl in the black dress again. We need to look at it. I think that's her too who wrote it, but I'm not sure yet. Now she's saying, I know he was at the table gambling. I saw him there, but I don't know him. She goes deep into it. Then she says, I saw him there, right here, but I don't know him. I know he was at the table gambling. So they're trying to see if it was part of the dice game or not. But then she said, I think he was with the people from Fifth Ward, but I'm from a leaf in the Southwest, so I don't know them. Right there, bro, they substantiating motives and reasons why you could blame, you feel me, the mob in them. And now this manager of the actual bowling alley is going to come through in the clutch with her own situation. You know that already, bro. The manager is going to bring a whole lot to it, bro. She's going to say it was X, Y, and Z. Everybody's gonna run with that narrative. Now let's listen to the 911. Does that substantiate that it might have been the manager, you feel me, who actually said that? Let's listen.
The people next door calling in about discharging firearms. It's not next door, it's from 2202. Possible discharging firearms or shooting, not sure which. And just Pinto at Dallas. Caller gunshots and people screaming.
Two shooting just occurred on SO San Jacinto in Dallas.
And if a site like this,
like, I don't know, bro, a situation like that, bro, you can hear it and you can, you feel me, bro, like you can hear what's going on to a certain extent, bro. I don't know. We got to do a video about the lady in the black dress. That's the one I'm doing next, man. But y'all tell me how y'all feel about this video, man, and how y'all feel about this manager of the bowling alley. Do you think she might be able to break the case since she's blaming the mob? Y'all tell me. We had to go through the rundowns. My pop's a pastor. He said precepts upon precepts when you covering anything. That means receipts and receipts to substantiate anything you saying. Look, man, I need y'all to smash that like button. Hit that notification bell. Thank you for rocking out with the movement. I am your guy, DJ Bless One. Blessings to I Smoke Hip Hop Nation, man. Look, I can't tell you to stay dangerous if you're staying safe already, man. Peace to the kings and queens. Love your family, love your kids. Stay blessed.